Dear Marco Rotnicek, dear Mr. Döpfner, ladies and gentlemen, we are living in a digital revolution. In the past, in the history, it was the IT sector, hardware, software, telecom, and now it's coming to the whole industry, to all sectors of our economy, to the whole society. In our global markets, we have some smart competitors, and they have a clear strategy. The US have a clear strategy. South Korea, maybe Japan, China, they have a clear strategy. And our idea is to come to a European strategy to Europeanize our digital policies, to come out from 28 and more fragmented markets, to come to one market with one regulation, with one common strategy. And no doubt, the availability of funding for young, fast-growing companies is an issue in Europe. In London, in Berlin, in Copenhagen, in Stockholm, in Munich, Hamburg, in Paris, and so on. One of the problems we have is that fast-growing companies need high amounts of money to go to the next stage. Specifically for unicorns in the making, like, and technology-oriented companies that want to launch a new product. Financing around 10 up to 40, 50 million euro are not unusual, but are difficult to obtain in Europe, even if the company has a proven track record. There are a number of reasons why scale-up companies are more problematic than startups when it comes to accessing the right level of finance as compared to the US. First reason, in Europe, the availability of venture capital is still limited, and venture capital funds are too small and are not able to support larger tickets as bigger investments are. A venture capital with a budget of 100 million cannot spend its entire budget on only a couple of companies. Second reason, closing a venture capital deal with a scale-up company in Europe takes too long, so that promising and impassioned scale-up companies are tempted to go elsewhere, to the US, to find the funding they need. And third reason, lack of involvement of large corporates as investors in young scale-up companies in Europe is an issue. In the US, large corporates seem to be more entrepreneurial and prone to take risks. Their innovation strategy is often based on the acquisition of young, innovative companies with promising new products or concepts. Dear colleagues, after this analysis, the question you might ask is what Europe is doing about these issues. Definitively, I can say that Europe is getting its act together, tackling different issues in a holistic manner. With our Digital Single Market Initiative, announced on 6th of May, we, the European Commission, are addressing the issue of fragmentation in the digital single market. Take data protection rules, take cybersecurity, take copyright, take cross-border infrastructure. We need a coordinated and coherent European approach. With this digital single market package, we are announcing our next steps to come to a functioning, completed single market with 510 million people, citizens, consumers, users, prosumers, and so this market can be the biggest market global-wide and can be interesting and attractive for investors, for startups, for our industries in a smart competition to the US, to South Korea, and to others. with our FC negotiations, means our European investment plan, just finished last week, we are confident that it will start operating as planned on 1st of July and inject in the next 2 years over 300 billion euros of much needed investment in our European economy. And we have clear priorities: highways, railway systems, and digital infrastructure are our three priorities. The structure of EFSI is all about attracting private investment by using public money as catalyst. Particularly for startups and scale-ups, the plans are extremely ambitious, and we hope to dramatically improve the availability of access to finance in Europe. The idea is to get money from insurance companies, from financial companies, minimizing risks, getting some guarantees and project bonds for to realize private investment more and more in our European Union. EFSI SME window will of course complement by approximately 3 billion euros already allocated to be invested via Infofin financial instruments till 2020. You have seen already the first highly innovative deals announced. Improving the investment climate and deepening the capital markets in Europe is one of the main objectives of the new Capital Markets Union initiative. The European Commission is determined to explore together with stakeholders how new ways of financing can be exploited, specifically for young, fast-growing companies, as you mainly are. Europe will have to stimulate the involvement of corporate and institutional investors to achieve a healthy investment and exit climate and to boost liquidity of secondary markets. One of the options is to set up a new large investment fund for scale-up companies. For instance, a new venture capital fund of funds through which large companies alongside with institutional investors could invest in young, promising companies. Backing these funds with a new EFSI fund might help to attract the institutional and corporate investors and to prevent that US funds will benefit from investment opportunities in Europe. Ladies and gentlemen, as mentioned, European companies must play a more active role in the improvement of exit climate for startups in Europe via mergers and via acquisitions. I wonder if it's normal that more than 50% of European startups are bought today by non-European companies. Crowdfunding could also play an important role to deepen the capital markets in Europe for startups, because of why crowdfunding works through matching on the internet. It has the potential to be quicker than our traditional investment, and there are clear signs that the volume is doubling every year and starts to complement investment via business angels or even via venture capital. Provided that investors can be sufficiently protected, equity crowdfunding can provide the amounts that young, fast-growing companies need. However, for this to be successful, we need a strong involvement of all stakeholders in the European startup ecosystem, from private investors to institutional investors to member states who should continuously improve their framework conditions for innovative startups. Only together we can succeed in the global competition. May I thank all the organizers of today's event. NOAA is a big chance for Europe. Starting in London, now being in Berlin, developed by NOAA hosts and organizers, supported by Axel Springer, I think your consortium, your network, is a good legal and economic and social framework for to bring Europe back into the game, into the global competition with startups and with financial investors. Both together, we can win. Thank you all.